Hey everyone, I'm Rebecca, a second year student adult nurse here at the University of Nottingham. Normally you can find me on YouTube at Rebecca B, where I talk all things nursing in university, but today I'm going to be talking to you about managing your mental health at university. Quick disclaimer before we start this video, although I am a student nurse, I'm not a student mental health nurse, I am an adult nurse and I am also not a registered nurse, I am not a registered healthcare professional, so I'm going to be talking about this from my personal experiences and the experiences of my friends, rather than a professional perspective. I'm going to go over a few of the frequently asked questions we get about managing mental health here at the University of Nottingham. The first question is, can I continue counselling and meds from my home GP at uni? So if you're like me, although I live in Nottingham during term time, my permanent home is in Mansfield, which is about 40 minutes away, so I am still a patient at my home GP. I go to there for all of my appointments. If you do not live as close to Nottingham as I do, there is a healthcare centre on University Park campus called Cripps Healthcare Centre, and they have designed that with a holistic approach. Holistic means that you see the person as a whole, so not just a physical illness, but also from mental health as well, and also religion and stuff like that. So not only do they have amazing facilities for physical health, such as a minor operation suite, they also have amazing facilities for mental health as well, including mental health suites that have been specifically designed to be used for that purpose. Second question is, how can I access the help if I need to while I'm at university? So the best thing to do is to either speak to the student services or speak to your personal tutor. I went to my personal tutor when I was finally brave enough to be able to say something that I was struggling, and he was the one who put me in contact with the welfare team. I had a meeting with a lovely lady from the welfare team. It was about 40 to 50 minutes long. She gave me a lot of coping strategies on how I could cope myself at home. She also asked if I wanted to access the counselling service. At that time, I declined because I wasn't ready. I didn't want to access that service, but there is the counselling service available if you feel like you need it. If you are thinking now that you're coming to university, you do counselling at home and you don't live close enough to your home GP and you would like to continue it here, then please tell your personal tutor or anybody in the first couple of weeks, just so they can get you on the waiting list, as it can be a little bit long. So make sure you're on that waiting list as soon as you can, but please find someone that you can speak to while you're on that waiting list. The third question is, am I going to be the only one managing my mental health? And the answer is absolutely not. Nearly everybody is going to be managing their mental health in some sort of way, whether it's a long-term condition that they've been diagnosed with for a while, or whether it's stress related to work. Everyone is going to be having issues with their mental health while being at university. So the best thing for you to do is to speak to others about it if you feel comfortable enough to, and build a support network around you so that you can get the help that you need. Fourth and final question that I'm going to be talking about today is, how am I going to be able to cope without my family? So university can be quite stressful. I was 18 when I moved to university, and moving away from my family for the first time was very scary. So I just wanted to tell you, everyone is in the same boat pretty much. Especially if you're moving into halls, it's probably going to be the first time that everybody has moved away from their family. So definitely speak to them about it. The only way that you're going to be able to get through it is if you make that good support network at university and speak to others about how you're struggling. Also, my peer mentor gave me some really good advice. Make some time for your family. I know at university you want to be having fun, going out, freshers week, and there's a lot of new work that you are going to have to be doing. You're trying to get used to the difference between school and university, and it's going to take up a lot of your time, but please make time for your family. Technology is amazing these days. Give them a call or a FaceTime every once in a while, and have a time dedicated to when you're going to go home to visit your family. You will appreciate it in the end, and your family will definitely appreciate it too. It will also give you something to look forward to if you're feeling homesick. Okay, so that's all from me at the moment about managing your mental health at university. The main thing that I want you to take away from this video is, please do not suffer in silence. Because I was brave enough and I spoke to my personal tutor and I got the help that I needed, I am doing a lot better than I was. So please, please do not be afraid to tell somebody that you're struggling. Here at the University of Nottingham, we are a massive community and we want to help each other, but we might not know that you need help if you don't tell somebody. We are so excited for you to be joining our community, and we will see you soon. Bye!